I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, it won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. Got every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes want to see is a glimpse of you. All I need is you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You know, we keep on thanking him and praising him and glorifying his holy name, just bathing in his presence. Amen. Bathing in a sense of, you know what, we're just sitting here in his presence. We're feeling the warmth of his love towards his children. Amen. His people. Well, we are his children. Amen. And the Lord is that good. Hallelujah. God is that great. You know what? Let us thank him for everything. Not only the food that we eat, but even to have the roof over our head, the clothes on our back, you know, just to be ever so grateful and thankful of the Lord. Of all in what he is doing. Amen. To be ever so grateful and thankful. You know, we never know when it's our time or close. Even to being in our time. You know, but God is an on-time God. Amen. You know, he wants us to see in his way. I remember a song that I would sing. And it was about Crystal Lewis that she sang the song. And I know I've shared it with y'all, maybe not here in the recent. But, you know, it talks about taking the hand of God and, you know, we're being led by God. We're being led by the Spirit because our eyes are closed, you know. And sometimes that's how we feel like in a process, that when our eyes are closed, but he's the one that's leading us, so we know that where we are going, that it is safe. And when after we come to a complete understanding of where we are at, and without us ridiculing, without us blaming, without us fussing, you know, where God has us, then he says, open your eyes. Amen. Open your eyes. And that's when he says, see what you have. Amen. See where I have brought you. See where I have opened up the heart and the minds of people, even those that surround you, that you may live in the greater blessing of the Lord. You know, many of y'all even here today may feel under a spirit of oppression, and maybe it's depression, and our reality, if you check it out, it might be just even the spirit of deception. Come on now. The enemy is conniving, and he wants to steal and kill and destroy everything, everything on earth that can probably even walk or dance or, you know, just praise the Lord. But he's deceiving by the thoughts of your mind. You know, a song was coming into spirit and in the spirit realm today, you know, about that we have a great, a good, good Father. You know, you may have had more than one in your life, or maybe you didn't even have not even one. You wish you had a father. But thank you, Jesus. God always makes a way where there seems to be no way, even in the way of the desert and in the wilderness. God is still God. And he is so loving and he is so giving that we can praise him, that we can worship him, that we can glorify him, that we can lift his name up. Because his name is to be so worthily praised. Thank you, Jesus. You know, we don't want to be just another number. We don't want to be just another number on the table. We don't want to be just another person there. You know, what good is a truck or a car that goes? But the tires don't work on it. Or they're all wobbly or flat. You know, what good is that? A car that can't go. And if it goes, it can barely go. Let's say if you have one in it, but you can't turn it on. You don't got no battery. Can move forward. You know, God wants us to move forward into the things of Christ. You know, there's a motto that's been said, keeping forward. Keeping forward. We must keep our faith. We must keep our faith walk. And trust God even in the midst of the small. That one tree. There's a big difference. Big difference in the Lord. A big difference in his presence. Oh, Jesus. He is a wonderful, wonderful Father. He is such a great Father. You know, God says here today that he even lavished his love on us. Oh, our God is a great, great, great Father. Oh, thank you, Jesus. He's a wonderful Father. He's a great Father. He's a great Father. He's a great Father. It's who I am, that I am loved by Him, by the Father and who He is. He is our Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, as we come here today, Father. Because you are our Father, Lord, and you know every person's circumstance. You know every situation. You know every scenario. You know our rising up and our laying down. You know what is to come, Lord. That our heart is set on you. Thank you, Jesus. Ora bakasa tayera bakaya. Help us to choose wisely, Lord. Hallelujah. The space into the circles, into the places where you would have this to be a witness, Lord. This to be a witness. We are loved by our Father. And God is the boss. And He is our loving Savior. Thank you, Lord, that you heal the mind. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. We're loved by you. Oh, thank you, Lord. Yeah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Well, thank you, brothers and sisters, for podcasting with me today. Amen. I really feel a restful, quiet, beautiful spirit in the Lord. Amen. And I pray that this prayer has answered a lot of requests. Receive the blessing. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Whatever we do, whatever we say, may it be unto the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. Blessings, church. Have a wonderful, wonderful day in the Lord. Amen.